Greetings, welcome to the Face of Shipping. Today we're in Washington, D.C. at U.S. Coast Guard headquarters, and it's the 25th of March, 2011, and we're with Jeffrey Lantz. Jeffrey is the Director of Commercial Regulations and Standards.
That's correct.
Quite a big title. Jeffrey, thank you for making time to speak to the seafarers. Can you tell them a little bit about the time you you served on board the vessels? I know you mentioned it was a brief time, but you had found that a significant value in your career. And perhaps more importantly, something about what you're doing now.
Very good. Well, thank you, George, for this opportunity. And yes, I started out in the Coast Guard a long time ago. And my first assignment after graduating from the Coast Guard Academy was on board a Coast Guard high endurance cutter, the U.S. Coast Guard cutter Boutwell. And that laid the foundation for the rest of my career, which has been in marine safety. I was fortunate enough to go on to graduate school. I'm a naval architect and marine engineer. And I've been able to spend my entire career in marine safety. And at my current job, I lead for the development of regulations and standards and policy for the safety, security, and environmental protection. And you know, a very critical role in doing that is to understand the role of the human element in the seafarer. And I can look back at being on board a ship and how valuable that is when we develop regulations. It is critically important that Coast Guard officers who are involved in marine safety and in writing regulations and enforcing regulations have that foundation of being at sea, understand what it's like to be on a rolling deck, being hot, being tired, being sweaty. It is perfect. You cannot underestimate the value.
I've been in committee or in the back of the room of the committee while you were leading many of them, not only at the IMO headquarters in London, but also in Manila at the revision of STCW last June. And so you're very much in the forefront of all of these activities, so many of which have direct effect on the seafarers' lives. And the revision of STCW comes in next year. The MLC is coming in next year. And there's a possibility you may be the new Secretary General of the IMO next year, so 2012, wow. Can you talk to the seafarers a little bit about some of those items and how those are going to affect their lives, revision of STCW and some of the things that are happening in session?
Right. Well, George, you're absolutely right. STCW is really a milestone. The 2010 amendments adopted in Manila completely revised STCW to take into account the changes we knew had to be made because of policy decisions, advancements in technology. But I think one of the most hard-fought decisions that we had to wrestle with was to ensure that seafarers had the maximum uninterrupted rest we could get. That was a very difficult issue, and it went down to the wire. And I am proud of being on the side working to get more rest for the seafarers. Speaking of IMO, the current Secretary General has made it a point to raise the profile of the issue of seafarers at IMO, and I couldn't support him more on that issue. Seafarers are they're so key, and as legislators at IMO, we need to always consider the impact on the seafarer when we're writing regulations. The human element is just critical. And the Secretary General and IMO has heightened the interest in seafarers from the updating STCW to evaluate piracy, to evaluate the shortage of seafarers. How can we get more seafarers in the industry? It is such a topical and crucial element that to develop and to address in the future.
Well, you're right, and Admiral Metropolis has made, or the IMO with his leadership, has made last year, 2010, the year of the seafarer, and he honored them by making the 25th of June the day of the seafarer forever. And this year, piracy orchestrating the response. Is that something you think you'll be continuing if you're in that position?
Absolutely. I think that piracy is the single largest issue facing the marine industry at this point in time. IMO has a crucial role to play in helping the world get rid of that scourge. IMO cannot directly deploy forces or intervene, but we provide a very valuable voice for the seafarer, for the maritime industry, for the owners, to bring their voice and their concern, and we can spread that message to all the countries to ensure that everybody does what is needed to reduce the risk of piracy?
Well, certainly the IMO 7-point plan is very important, and I think we're all behind you, supporting you and the other leaders of the IMO committees. And you are leading how many committees now? You're chairing the IMO?
Well, I'm not chairing any committees at this point in time. I have the great honor of leading the U.S. delegation to both the Marine Safety Committee and the Marine Environmental Protection Committee. And I also have the additional honor of being elected as the council chairman for IMO, which is the highest body that you can be elected to, aside from the Secretary General.
Wow, that's a lot of responsibility. And always, I was with you in Manila at the out session. We were working on the that final part for the rest hours of the Seafarers, and it was a very, very important time, perhaps one of the most, or the most important meeting I've ever sat in terms of what actually came out of it. And I know you were leading that part of it so strongly, so you know, I thank you for that part of it on behalf of the Seafarers. I know your time is beyond saying busy, but are there any other things you'd like to say for the Seafarers, perhaps some parting advice or comments that they could impart from you? You've had so much range of exposure on the highest levels.
Well, I don't have any advice for Seafarers. I have the utmost respect for Seafarers. I think that Seafarers need to keep reminding us of their value to the industry, and they need to keep reminding us that we need to consider their value when we do the legislation and the regulations. I think it's a wonderful profession, and I hope that we are able to attract more young men and women into that profession in the future.
Well, communication is really only effective if it's two ways. Mr. Lantz has taken the time out of his schedule to speak to you. If you have some comments, suggestions, or questions, positive or negative, please send them to Newslink. We'll consolidate them and bring them to Mr. Lantz and his team for a review so that they can get direct input from you. And on behalf of Seafarers, thank you for making time to talk to them, and we wish you very safe sailing.
George, thank you very much for this opportunity.